The global population, with a specific focus on Uganda, is steadily increasing each day. This necessitates a corresponding growth in food production, as human survival is contingent on sustenance. Agriculture remains indispensable to humanity, underscoring the need for innovation. One notable innovation is the farming of black soldier flies. In our inaugural episode exploring black soldier fly farming, we will dive into the intricacies of how to engage in this innovative agriculture practice. Without further delay, let's commence today's show by examining the essential aspects of black soldier fly farming. Black soldier flies possess the capability to produce and metabolize unsaturated fatty acids, crucial in the dietary requirements of livestock. Additionally, black soldier fly larvae are abundant in essential minerals such as calcium, iron, magnesium, sodium, zinc, and potassium, playing a vital role in the nutritional needs of both humans and animals. From an environmental standpoint, black soldier fly larvae contributes to waste degradation, mitigating pollution. Moreover, the production process not only addresses environmental concerns, but also generates job opportunities, adding societal value. In a recent exploration of the Women Income Network, where black soldier flies are cultivated, Martini Janfa, one of the co-founders, shared the farm's background and inception story. In today's episode, we engage with Ogwang Morris, the farm manager who guides us on the essentials of initiating a black soldier flies farm, detailing the necessary requirements and associated costs.
This enterprise is a very unique enterprise. That if somebody would start with this to do the black soldier flies, the first point this person must source organic waste, because organic waste is the most important thing someone should start with. And we believe Uganda producing around 1,500 tons every single day is a great opportunity for somebody to venture into this technology. Working with these insects, most times when you look at the maggot stage or the larva stage, it entirely survives on feeding on organic waste. So most times the waste they produced in the cities, they have inorganic and organic. So most times a farmer should first separate the inorganic, which comprises of the caveras, comprises of the plastics, comprises of glasses. So most times these are separated off. Then we use the organic, which comprises of fruit waste and vegetable waste. Purely dumped fresh waste is the most suitable waste because it contains most of the food nutrients which are required by these insects. When you have your waste collected, most times we need a drum where we can put our organic waste in and we seal it off. So that waste can always be utilized at any time, provided it is trying to decompose. That is the most suitable waste we can use. Every single day we use around 200 kilograms every single day of organic waste.
Waste plays a crucial role in the black soldier fly farming process, serving as the primary feed during the maggot cycle. At the Women Income Network, they receive 1.25 tons of organic waste weekly, and on the farm, 200 kilograms of waste are utilized to nourish the maggots, as explained by Maurice Ogwang, the farm manager.
Most times, it depends on the production capacity a farmer has on their farm. Now, for us here, the production capacity permits us to use 200 kilograms of organic waste every single day. But then, every single week, as I mentioned lately, we always receive about 1.25 tons every single week, constituting to around 5 tons, as you mentioned earlier. Now, when we receive the organic waste here at the farm, what we do, we believe that Ugandans, they've never understood how best they can separate the non-biodegradable materials from the biodegradable materials. So what we do, after receiving the organic waste here at the farm, we sort and separate. So after separating, we only take the degradable organic waste. So what we do, we have a shredding machine. Now this shredding machine, it is fabricated here in Uganda and it is locally available. So that shredding machine, it is where we put the fresh organic waste, which comprises of vegetables and fruits. So the machine crushes it down into small sizable pieces that our maggots can crush down in a short period of time. However, this machine is a little expensive for starters, but then it is not a limitation because farmers can still get the organic waste and crush it traditionally with a panga or anything that can help in chopping it down to pieces. The reason as to why we chop it or shred it is because we want to ease and we want to shorten the growth rate of these maggots. Otherwise, if something is hard enough, the maggots would take some more time in crushing it down.
Farming black soldier flies is an emerging enterprise in Uganda, gaining significant relevance in the agriculture sector. This has sparked a keen interest among farmers, leading to numerous inquiries. As demonstrated on the Harvest Money Show, extensive research is essential to address these questions and acquire a deeper understanding. Ogwang provides insights into the crucial factors one should be aware of before entering this business.
We juggle through the life cycle of this insect. So the adult fly, it is the first stage of the black soldier fly. Now the adult fly, it is the one that will lay for us eggs. And each single fly will give us between 800 eggs to 1,000 eggs. Every single time it lays the eggs. So after laying the 800 and 1,000 eggs in between, that highly depends on how you feed the larva stage. If you feed the larva stage pretty well, it will produce a great fly, a mature and well-sizable fly that will give you up to 1,000 eggs. So the fly will give us eggs. Eggs will be harvested. After harvesting these eggs, we shall introduce the eggs in a substrate that enables it to hatch into a young larvae. Now the substrate I'm talking about could be in form of any energy source. That is the maize bran, could be rice bran, could be brewery waste. So after hatching into the young larvae, it hatches in a short period of time of 5 days. So after hatching, the young larvae will then be introduced to the crushed organic waste. So it will crush down the organic waste into the maggots that could be harvestable and fed to the livestock, or even the fertilizer that can be taken back to our fields or the garden. But then, still if we are looking at sustainability, the maggots can be left to further grow and then turn into another stage, which is the pupa stage. So it is the pupa stage that we shall later on bring back to the nets. And these nets that I'm talking about are the untreated nets. So these untreated nets are most times situated under a transparent sheet, because these flies, after hatching from the pupa which has been put here, they like natural lighting because this enhances them and helps them in laying and mating.
What are the fundamental prerequisites for setting up a black soldier fly farm?
For you to start a farm, you must have the structures available. Okay, there are some factors that you need to have in place to do this kind of enterprise. Now, we need the structure being erected. We need organic waste source being sited. That's when you can continue and start. And then the stage you can start with, you can easily start with any stage. It could be the pupa stage, which is dormant stage. You can move with it and you can put it anywhere. Or you can start with the egg stage. This can still also be transferable. Or you can start with the young larvae. Any stage that you start with depends on where you are going to put it and how ready you are. When you are starting with the pupa stage, you must have a structure that has transparent sheets to allow in the light rays, because the pupa stage will hatch into the flies and these flies need light to mate and lay. If you start, or if you take the eggs, you need the hatchery where the eggs must hatch from. If you start with the young larvae, you must be in position to secure the organic waste where the larvae or the young larvae will feed on.
Which seed stock is recommended for novice farmers, and is it readily accessible in the market?
Here at the farm, we do provide stock. We call them parent stock. We have a package. We have a package of all the three stages. That is when a farmer is totally sure of all the conducive environment for every single stage. So if that's so, then they can go with the parent stock of the complete. Or if the farmer is saying, me, I want to be in position to go with the other stages, be it the black soldier fly or the adult stage, because it needs light and a specific room. But then they have cart drums, they have containers, they have basins, they have anything they can leverage on as a rearing pond. We can give them the eggs, or we can give them the young maggots.
An essential condition for the optimal development of black soldier flies and their larvae is a conducive environment. The inquiry revolves around defining the characteristics that constitute an ideal environment for their growth.
Now, when you look at the adult stage, it needs an environment that allows in natural lighting. That's where you will need transparent sheets that will emit in the direct sunlight, because these must use that light in mating and laying eggs. Other conditions that are very favorable for other stages, like the pupa or the larva stage, they need a conducive environment that is more with less light. So that's where they will grow very well. And if you look at the eggs will need a hatchery which is already shielded off from direct sunlight, because of course the eggs will dry, or it should be shielded from direct rainfall.
The forefront concerns when venturing into business is invariably the capital issue. In our conversation with Ogwang, he vividly portrayed the financial landscape one must navigate when initiating a black soldier fly farm.
To start, most times the first thing that I advise farmers to use is first of all to realize the potential things they have in the place. That is, they could be having old jerry cans, so they can start with old jerry cans. But then looking at this in line of business, somebody can start with 150, because with 150 you can make shelves and then buy jerry cans, then cut the jerry cans, then stack them in form of the shelves. Then you can start from there. Somebody could be like, I want something a little bigger. You can use something like 500,000 to have a structure which is shielded off from with the transparent cavella or the deep or the UV polythene. And then on the back you can use you can recycle sacks. This could be sacks from sacks of posho, so you can get the sacks then shield off your structure, provided rain doesn't leak through.
Do black soldier flies exhibit distinct breeds?
Now, when you look at insects, we have very many insects, thousands and thousands of insects. But then when you come to a specific insect or breed we are looking at in here, we are looking at the black soldier flies. And it doesn't have any other breed or any other type. It is purely the black soldier fly. When you come to me, when you come to our farm, when you come to any farmer who is doing the black soldier fly, you only ask for a stage. That I want the eggs, I want the pupa stage, I want the maggot stage. But then we will not ask for any kind of a type or a breed of the black soldier fly. It is always one.
Nowadays, agriculture is conducted as a commercial venture. In our conversation with Maurice Ogwang, we endeavored to identify the profitability in raising the black soldier fly.
Now, when you look at the black soldier fly technology, it is still a very virgin business here in Uganda. And there are very many stages in it that we can earn a living from or money from. Now, remember, the black soldier fly larvae entirely survives on organic waste. So you will not need to buy organic waste. Organic waste is, we have a lot here in Uganda. Now, the black soldier fly, we can sell the pupa stage, and each kilogram of pupa stage, it is 10,000. So that is money. When you come to the larva
stage, that's what you call the maggot.
No, that is the pupa stage. They have four stages. So they have the adult fly, which lays the eggs. So we have eggs. We have eggs will hatch into larva. So we have larvae. So the larvae, if it grows further, it will turn into the pupa. So the most, the fourth stage is the one that I'm referring as pupa. And each stage of it, or each kilo of it, is 10,000. It is 10,000. Each kilo. Each kilo of pupa stage is 10,000.
Let me talk to you about the eggs. Can I, are these eggs, this, that you can see, can you see them by your eyes?
Yeah, these, the eggs for the black soldier flies are visible, and they are characterized by being with a rice shape. They are rice shaped and they are always yellow in color. Most times, if the black soldier fly has just ovipositated the eggs are whitish in color. But after a few hours, they turn to yellowish.
How much time must pass for someone who has initiated a black soldier fly farm to commence harvesting and generating income?
Now, like for any other business, we always have a break-even point. Most times you need to first reach the break-even point to start realizing your profits. But then we assume somebody has already a structure they are going to leverage on. Somebody has already a container or jerry cans which are old to leverage on. Somebody can start earning money in just a month. Yes, because when you buy your eggs, you can introduce them to the hatchery and then they hatch. Now, after that, in a period of 2 weeks to a month, you have your larvae you can sell, or you have your pupae you can sell.
What does the mathematics entail when considering the quantity of eggs to purchase and the corresponding waiting period until harvest?
Now, I'll give you an example that is very small and very understandable. When you start with 1 gram, when you buy 1 gram of eggs, that is 2,000. And other people sell it at 2,500. Now, when you get 1 gram of eggs, now, that 1 gram of eggs will hatch into larvae, and at a fresh form or harvestable stage, those will be 2 kilograms of fresh maggots. Now, when you sell them at a cost of 3,000 each kilogram, you already have 6,000. The reason as to why we weigh the eggs, we want to understand how much organic waste shall we need. Because this is a business that we are looking at. How much organic waste will you need? Because sometimes organic waste obtaining it may not be at a free cost. You may be having people you are hiring to get for your organic waste. So you must see this as a business that you must also weigh the organic waste and how much they must eat. So 1 gram of eggs will crush down 5 kilograms of organic waste. 1 gram of eggs after hatching into young larvae, they will crush down that organic waste. They will crush down that 5 kg of organic waste. We sell in grams. Each gram is 2,000. And other people can sell it at 2,500. A gram, a single gram like this. I can't count. There are millions and millions.
What difficulties might individuals anticipate when aspiring to become part of a black soldier fly farm?
Now, when you look at any kind of business, always have challenges. Now, when you look at an enterprise like the black soldier fly, we always have challenges of rats. Rats are great feeders on the black soldier fly because it has the protein. So the rats would want to eat the protein. So they will come and they feed on it. So the best thing to eradicate is to have a pushcart in your building or structure. Another challenge that you have is collecting waste. Most times waste comes with a lot of impurities, or I must say the non-biodegradable materials such as the calaveras, because Ugandans don't know how to separate organic from the inorganic. So we always have challenges in hiring. That is an extra cost, people who are passing separating. We also have a challenge of removing or reducing water from the organic waste. Most times there are seasons whereby you have a lot of cucumbers, watermelons, and these are what we can use. So when they come here, they are close to watery or they are in porridge form. So we need to get an extra cost in reducing the water. That could be in form of
waste.
Yes, in waste. We need to remove excess water. Otherwise, our young larvae or maggots will end up escaping and they will take long to grow. So we need something like any dry organic stuff, like rice husks, like the maize bran, like any bran that can help us in absorbing excess water. Another challenge that we have is season. Most times in wet season, the conditions are unfavorable for our parents, the adult stage, because they are the ones that lay eggs, and then also that's when they need to multiply. So in absence of light, or in absence of enough heat, the black soldier flies won't be in position to lay eggs as we expect them. So during our rainy season, we always have that challenge of having a continued production.
Black soldier fly larvae are rich in calcium and phosphorus, containing approximately 35 to 42% krill protein. They exhibit a biological value and amino acid profile comparable to soybean meal. This makes them a valuable element in animal feeds, serving as a potential substitute for silverfish and eliminating the time-consuming process of cultivating soybeans. In essence, black soldier fly farming emerges as a practical solution, offering a promising business opportunity for those interested in agriculture. I trust this information has provided insight into the potential of the black soldier fly farming business. If you are considering joining this venture, seize the opportunity. And this concludes our discussion on the Harvest Money Show for this week.